Chicago, because we're going to zero in on this date, September 1st, 1972. This is one of the greatest classics of all time, the cage match of this night. Let me tell you, nobody that witnessed this will ever forget it. And for those of you who did not witness it, we're going to play it again, Sam, because I want to tell you, this really gets ugly. This is what you call cage action with no heart. No heart, no soul. These poor guys, no love lost between the two teams. Dick the Bruiser and the Crusher at the height of their career. One of the toughest in the history of the sport. They were never tougher than this night in 72. In fact, we had to go and get the best, toughest referee we could find to handle the match. Jersey Joe Walcott, the former world heavyweight boxing champion, and you see him right there coming in and out of your screen. That's right, Jersey Joe Walcott. And the night before this match, we had Jersey Joe in the same studio with these four guys trying to lay down certain rules. Rules, you know, for the betterment of, you know, of being kind to one another, to the sense of we just want out and out slaughter, you know. But they didn't even hardly want to talk to each other in the sense of discussing rules. When they left the meeting, they almost got in a big brawl right there. And the bottom line was, no rules. That's right, no rule, no time limit, no disqualification, no mercy. Those were the rules that they decided on. And brother, this is the way it unfolded. Here, as you watch, keep in mind that this battle went on for about 35 minutes. So we're not showing the 35 minutes. We're showing the highlights of the match. And in these highlights, you're going to see certain things that you will never see in a cage match in your life. Number one, you're going to see Jersey Joe Walcott, the referee, actually go out of control in the sense that he couldn't handle the idea of being in that ring and all that violence unfolding around him without really venting his emotions. So he lets Heenan have it towards the end of the match. Plus, at the end of the match, you'll see Heenan vomit in the corner, vomit blood in the corner, and try to shield his face because he didn't want the cameraman to take this film of him vomiting. But he was, hey, you get thudded against that wire for 35, 38 minutes. Hey, brother, your stomach's upside down and your system ain't in control anymore. And let me tell you, he was loose as a goose in the sense he couldn't control anything, brother. So he just, that was it. There's pretty boy Bobby Heenan taking that punishment there. And now we got, whoa, Dick the Bruiser is coming in off that rope. This is rough and tough action. The roughest, the toughest that you'll ever see. Here comes Dick the Bruiser. He's pounding on Blackjack Mulligan. Let me tell you, Blackjack Mulligan, how tough is Mulligan? Hey, a guy came in the ring in Boston and cut him up one side and down the other. He took 200 stitches right after he got in a wrestling game. He almost bled to death because nobody wanted to go into the ring and take the knife off the guy that cut him. Finally, a Boston policeman jumped in and they subdued, with the help of one of his partners, the knife wielder. And our friend Blackjack Mulligan was saved from death. And what do you think? Hey, he was back in action. Scars running up and down his body. He was back in action 2 months later. And I want to tell you, that's how tough and rough he was. He was tough. He didn't care. And Lanza didn't care. And Bruiser didn't care. Hey, we got four guys that just didn't care. And you think that they ever asked for time? Did you think they ever said, stop it? You think they ever turned to Walcott and said, hey, stop it? I want to tell you, we were right there at ringside. Nobody said nothing. They just kept pounding each other until finally, when it was all over, the Lanza and Mulligan really couldn't continue. But more than that, Heenan was really out of it, and so the match was over, and Dick the Bruiser and the Crusher had won. But I tell you something, it wasn't a clear-cut victory, because Bruiser and Crusher had a lot of damage to themselves. Both of them were bleeding. Look, there! There, you just saw that! Walcott just gave him a shot, and Heenan's down! See, Walcott was out of control this night. It was incredible. I couldn't believe my eyes. Here we are at Soldier Field, site of the Bears, where they play them great wild and woolly football games. Them great NFL stars pounding on each other. I'll tell you something, Soldier Field never had four guys pounding like this in any football game you'll ever see. And there they are trying to escape now. You think they're trying to escape for some unusual reason? No, they're just trying to escape the punishment, that's all. They just want to get out of there. They want to get away from the punishment. Hey, the blows are raining on them. I'll tell you something. Look at the grabbing Heenan, pulling him around. There, you see Mulligan bleeding. Now, Walcott's already, he counted him down, and that's it. Walcott says, look at, that's it. That's the pin. That's the match. But look at Lanza. Lanza says, wait a minute. There is no time limit, but there is in this sense. See, Mulligan has hurt his knee. But still he could continue. But this is, look at this, is ugly. Look at this. Heenan throwing him into that fence. That's what you call sadism, brother. That's what you call monstrousism or whateverism. This is bad. This is what you call brutality in wrestling at its worst. And don't ever forget it, fans. Don't ever forget this match, because this was the wildest, greatest, the most brutal cage match ever. And it's a Hall of Fame classics that will live forever. And every time it's played, wherever it's played, people are going to go and flinch and maybe cry. And they're going to scream and they're going to moan. But that's all right. We want you to see the best of the best on the Hall of Fame classic. Now he is throwing up. Hey, that's what I call, hey, he gave it all, Bobby boy. You gave everything you had. And I know that you don't like us to see this, but let's show it to the fans to see what ugly is in wrestling. That's where it was then.